computer architecture. Let's take a second look at this 6500 family of processors that we've seen already in the last lecture. Remember what I'm talking about? This is the computer here, the Commodore 64, or the Apple and the Apple II. Very famous, landmarks in computer science. So this was the computer that people normally had at home, 64 kilobytes. And of course, I also programmed on that, but that was on BASIC. Of course, on that time, I didn't know anything about assembly or about how this entire thing works. And I told you that it also featured in the Terminator, which I find quite funny. So for you to remember this, if you see this, that you know that, oh yes, this is the computer of the Terminator, apparently. A little bit strange, but funny anyway. Now, last I left you with the lecture, I left you here with this 16 different addressing modes, and I explained to you how the zero page mode works, that you have the next operand, the next byte in memory after the opcode, which is 8-bit, you get, it loads another 8-bit, and this 8-bit A value then becomes the zero address. It is filled 16 bits in total, the address line, so zeros and then the A, and this will be the zero page. But let's now take a look at an example in how it would work in assembly. So imagine I want to have this these instructions. Here are all the instructions. There were, let me see, I think 70. There are 70 different instructions. Here you see the mnemonics, and here they say what they're doing. Now, so I took an example. Let me put jump. Jump to. I think we all know what this means. Let's take this example. But before I want to show you to how this jump works, note again that there is no multiply and there is no division. So let's take a look at that later on. But here, jump to. I want to do jump to. And what kind of jump to do I want? I want jump to absolute mode. So in this case, I have to have the opcode, which we'll look in the table in a moment. Opcode for jump to absolute. And then we have to supply the address in 2 bytes. So what I want is, imagine jump to address FF00 hexadecimal. So I want jump to absolute addressing mode. Then the next 2 bytes are the address. So let's take a look at the table. What means, I have to put this on the side. I have to put this one on the side. This is the chip. We don't need this anymore. I want to have here the table of opcodes. Yes, this is the one that I wanted. Here we have all the opcodes. And let me see, where do we have jump to? Jump to, exactly. Jump, absolute. This is, they have here the most significant nibble and the least significant nibble. So this jump absolute is for C. So jump, if we are going to assemble our program, jump absolute is for C. And then we have to, of course, to do this FF00. But the funny thing is that we have to put it in reverse order. First, we have to supply the least significant byte and then the most significant byte of the address. So in hexadecimal, this instruction jump absolute to address FF00 would become in machine language hexadecimal 4C00FF. And 4C00FF then in binary would be 0100 1100 0000 0000 0000 1111111, because these 111s are these Fs, these 0000s are these zeros, and C is 1100, and 4, as you know, is 0100. So this code, which we have in memory, would represent jump absolute to address FF00. So as you can see here, there are 70 different, 70, or I should look at, tell you this one. There are 70 different operations, basic operations, but they have 16 different addressing modes. So in principle, you have 16, not all of them will be used, but you have 16 times 70. not all combinations are used. So in total, these are all the instructions possible. And if you see with two nibbles, 8-bit, then you can have 256 different instructions. And as you can see, nearly all instructions, nearly all bit patterns are used. There's only a few open holes in here of bit patterns that are not representing any operation. So this is what you get, 70 instructions with 16 possible addressing modes, and then you have 256 total, nearly, well, I think it's about 200 probably. And you can see here some examples as what is funny. Let me see if I can get some example. This is load, of course you have here load. We have probably also store in memory. We have, which I want to see is something that is doesn't have, the other one doesn't have, yeah, increment. So that is just incrementing the X register or Y register or memory or the accumulator by just one. So imagine that you're writing a for loop, and you, as you know, in 99.9% of all the for loops, the iterator variable is incremented by one. So it's nice that you have this already implemented in your assembly. Then these instructions are much faster. And as you can see, in X, where do we have in X here? I cannot find it so fast. It is then, so I will not talk about it. This is some special features that this processor has. 70 instructions, 16 addressing modes, and here are all the instructions possible, and here was an example. Oh yeah, and I wanted to not forget to tell you that there is no multiply, as you can see, no multiply, there's also no division, and as we have seen already by the Intel 4004, how this is done. If not, if you forgot, please go back to that lecture, how you can with rotate. Here we have rotate left, rotate right, and you have this carry bits and so on, how you can then implement the Russian peasant algorithm for multiplications. And once you have multiplications, then of course you have also divisions, because a division is a multiplication by its reciprocal. Okay, so this ends here the 6500 family. I only want to mention why I don't call it 6502. That is because it was an entire family, there was an evolution, 6502, then went into 6510, etc., etc. And the difference is, for instance, between these two is that they have one, the 10 had a built-in input-output port. But for the rest, it was basically the same. And every now and then, some small differences were made, and some instructions were added. But basically, this is the instruction set.